Approximately 100 million years ago, the Earth had a drastically different appearance. Devoid of human presence and inhabited by formidable creatures known as dinosaurs. These dinosaurs were colossal, towering over buildings, possessed powerful jaws capable of crushing any bones in an instant, and sprinted at astonishing speeds of around 90 kilometers per hour, making them truly fear-arousing creatures. They ruled the Earth for over 170 million years. But then one day, something happened that wiped them out completely from this Earth. Exactly what happened? And how? Let's find this out in today's video. The origin of the word dinosaur can be traced back to Greek, with denios meaning terrible and sauros meaning lizard, literally translating to terrible lizard. This term was first used in 1841 by British scientist Richard Owen, when the first dinosaur fossil was discovered. Megalosaurus was one of the first fossil to be discovered by the human. The initial drawing of Megalosaurus was like this. Early depictions of dinosaurs were quite different from our current understanding, but as researchers unearthed more information, they gradually refined their depictions to be more realistic. Today, paleontologists have uncovered over 10,000 dinosaur fossils worldwide, identifying more than 900 distinct species. Surprisingly, from 2003 to 2022, an average of 45 new dinosaur species were identified each year, indicating that the work of paleontologists is far from over. Some of the photos of the new species of dinosaurs discovered recently are. To understand the story of dinosaurs, we must journey back in time to millions of years ago. Scientists estimate the first dinosaur emerged around 230 to 40 million years ago during the Triassic period. The oldest dinosaur fossils discovered by scientists was in Africa, and it was almost 231.4 million years old. Earth looked vastly different then, with all continents joined together in a supercontinent called Pangaea. The climate was arid, dry with a little rain. This was Triassic period. Dinosaurs of that era were relatively small, with some common species measuring around 2 meters in length. For instance, E. raptor was present in that period. This was in fact the ancestors of other dinosaurs. Most prevalent species of this era was giant reptiles. Around 201 million years ago, the Triassic period ended as Earth's climate underwent significant changes. Pangaea began breaking apart due to geological shifts, and massive volcanic eruptions released carbon dioxide and sulfur dioxide into the atmosphere, leading to global warming, acidification of oceans, and rapid climate change. Most species, especially cold-blooded reptiles, couldn't adapt to these temperature fluctuations, but dinosaurs, being warm-blooded like human, were better equipped to endure the changes. This extreme climate change and volcanic eruptions was present for over 600,000 years, causing almost all the other species to extinction. Dinosaurs, crocodiles, turtles and early mammals were the only animal that were present on Earth at that time. This period of turmoil and environmental shifts, known as the Triassic-Jurassic extinction event, marked the end of the Triassic period and the beginning of the Jurassic period. During the Jurassic period that lasted from 201 million to 145 million years ago, dinosaurs continued to evolve, some growing significantly in size like some of the earliest Titanosaurus. They weighed up to 15,000 kilograms and were 15 meters long. Due to the evolution at that time, flying dinosaurs like Archaeopteryx also made their appearance. Pangaea divided into two smaller supercontinents, Laurasia and Gondwanaland, and the climate became warmer. However, it was in the subsequent Cretaceous period, spanning from around 145 to 65 million years ago, that dinosaurs experienced a remarkable surge in diversity. New species emerged, including the famous T-Rex, which is often associated with the Jurassic period due to the Jurassic Park films, but actually lived during Cretaceous period. The continents continued to shift and new species of dinosaurs thrived. Several flowering plants evolved at this time, as Earth was warmer than the past. Almost all kinds of dinosaurs that you can imagine was present at this time, like raptors, armored dinosaurs, giant herbivorous dinosaur, dangerous carnivorous dinosaurs. The apex predator at this time was Titanosaurus, one of the largest at that time, Titanosaurus, which weighed up to 77 tons, and
T-Rex, that was up to 40 feet long.
Quetzalcoatlus was the largest flying dinosaur with wingspan of 10 to 11 meters.
This was the most comfortable era for dinosaurs, and there were no species to compete with them.
Dinosaurs were truly ruling over the world at this time.
Then, approximately 66 million years ago, a catastrophic event unfolded. A colossal asteroid, measuring around 10 to 15 kilometers in diameter, hurtled toward Earth, impacting the Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico with unimaginable force.
This event, known as the Cretaceous-Paleogene KPG extinction event, had devastating consequences.
This asteroid crashed into Earth having speed of 30 kilometers per second, which is 150 times faster than a jet airliner. This created a large crater of diameter 180 kilometers in Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico. It generated immense energy.
The asteroid produced 1 billion times more than the energy produced by the atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
This caused wildfires for thousands of kilometers.
Tsunamis that made 2-kilometer-tall waves.
Earthquakes. And volcanic eruptions.
The impact also released an enormous amount of dust particles into the atmosphere,
blocking sunlight and triggering a nuclear winter that lasted for years.
This catastrophic event resulted in the extinction of most plant and animal species, as it was impossible for plants to use photosynthesis because of the absence of sunlight. Plants died.
The herbivorous died because there was no plant to eat to survive. And eventually, as a chain reaction in food chain, carnivores also died.
Only small omnivorous animals like mammals, lizards, turtles, and some bird could survive this because of their scavenger nature.
Did dinosaurs, fungus, decaying plant matter was the food for these small omnivores?
One asteroid changed history of Earth for the next thousands of years.
More than 75% of animals and plants went extinct.
After this mass extinction, the Paleogene period began, heralding a new era on Earth. Mammals, birds, reptiles, and other creatures filled the ecological niches left vacant by the extinct dinosaurs. Humans should be thankful for this asteroid because this awarded a good opportunity for the evolution of mammals.
Some mammals, like horses,
whales,
bats,
and primates,
underwent significant evolution during this period. Notably, birds, the descendants of flying dinosaurs, continue to thrive and diversify. The flying dinosaur are the ancestors of the birds that we see flying around today.
Specifically, ancestry is shared most closely by chickens and ostriches.
The closest living relative of mighty T-Rex dinosaur is a chicken.
You might have a question about the asteroid. How did we find out about the spot where the asteroid crashed, as well as the exact time of the crash? A rare mineral, iridium, has proved it. At a few places on Earth, scientists found a high concentration of iridium on the ground.
The analyzation of Earth by geologists found that it is a very rare mineral on Earth. But interestingly, it is so abundant on our ground. How is this possible? On the other hand, comets and asteroids have a high concentration of iridium.
By putting the iridium into carbon dating, scientists have found that the iridium layer that we find is 66 million years old.
This could happen only when the asteroid hit the planet, and in the aftermath, this mineral spread all around the globe.
You might wonder that since the asteroid had an impact this big, we should be able to see the crater it left on Earth.
Yes, you are right. The crater is hidden in Yucatan Peninsula, and several digging expeditions confirmed that it happened and exact location was also identified. This is the exact location in the map.
Half of it is submerged in water, and the other half is on land. These cenotes in this Mexican area can be found in a ring formation around the crater. They are famous tourist attractions nowadays. These cenotes form the world's largest underground cave system.
In modern times, humans are facing a different kind of extinction event, known as the Holocene extinction event, primarily caused by human activities such as deforestation,
pollution, and habitat destruction. This event has led to a rapid loss of biodiversity, with many species becoming endangered or extinct. Efforts are being made to address this crisis and protect the planet's ecosystems.
In conclusion, the history of Earth is marked by the rise and fall of various species, with dinosaurs dominating the planet for a remarkable duration. However, they met their end in a cataclysmic event, making way for the evolution of mammals and other life forms. The history of dinosaurs serves as a testament to the ever-changing nature of our planet and the importance of preserving its biodiversity for the future. Thank you everyone for watching this video.